So you've been looking how to add some fun effects to your videos. Well, in today's tutorial, we'll be showing you how to create the freeze effect. You know, the one that goes like this. And you see, it's quite simple. Let's get started. If you're already subscribed to the channel, well, thank you so much. And if you haven't already, well, think about doing so. And without further ado, let's jump into Fusion. So right here, we have a clip from the last video we published on YouTube. Actually, it's a fun little one, and if you haven't watched it already, here's a link so you can check it out. And now, we're gonna start by playing the clip once and see how we apply the freeze effect. Pretty cool, right? Okay, so what's happening here? There's a clear separation between the foreground and the background, both in terms of color and motion, and we'll see how to adjust every bit of it to apply to your personal taste. Oh, one more thing. All the files necessary to practice along the tutorial are available right in the description. Now we can start. Okay, as you can see, I already copied one original piece of footage. The first thing we want to do is to freeze the frame right where we want to apply the effect. So we're gonna play through, pause, split. We're going to right click on the part of the clip, choose retime control, and right here, you're going to click on the little arrow and choose freeze frame. Automatically, this is going to add several frames and then go back to the normal speed. So we're going to go at the end of the freeze frame, split again. Depending if you need the action to go back to normal, you can keep or delete the rest of the footage. In our case, we don't really need it, so I'm going to delete the third part. We can close the retime control by clicking on the little X. Okay. And now we're going to duplicate the frozen frames and bring them to an upper track. This to add later on some parallax effect. To do this, press Alt, select your clip, and drag it. I'm leaving an empty track in between, right click on the upper track and choose Open in Fusion Page. As usual, we have our media in, which is our footage, and the media out, which is the output that will be rendered. To achieve this effect, we are going to need a mask. For this, click on the polygon icon. We're going to detach the polygon node by pressing Shift and dragging it away, so we can see what we're doing. While the polygon node is selected, I'm going to zoom in by pressing Ctrl and scrolling. And now we're going to create a mask by adding point after point. While pressing on the mouse, you can drag to add some curve to your polygon. Don't worry, you can always correct your mask later on if needed. So I'm going to trace a mask. And actually, I'm going to speed up through the process so it doesn't take too long. As you can see, you can easily correct and adjust the curve so it matches perfectly your clip. If you create a point by mistake and you want to delete it, just select it and press backspace. Okay, and to finish, I'm going to close the polygon by clicking on the first point. Okay, it's pretty good, not perfect, but there's one thing that bugs me. If you look attentively, Blue's glasses, they are not masked. We're gonna ignore the branch, but I would like at least that we can do a cutout inside. I'm just going to adjust the frame by pulling the points here. Let's zoom in. And actually, I'm gonna add an extra point just by clicking on the line. I'm gonna do a simple correction. Again, you can always come back and adjust the shape. If you need to smooth out something, you can use the smooth button to add some curve to your handles. Now, before we deal with Blue's glasses, we can already connect our polygon to the media in. And as you can see, we maxed out Blue's surrounding. Okay, let's zoom in and create a second mask to take care of the glasses. Make sure that nothing is selected. Click on the polygon icon so we can see what we're doing. I'm gonna zoom in a bit. And we're just going to mask out. Close. Now we can connect the second polygon to the first one. With the second polygon selected, we're gonna click invert. Go to polygon number one. And here we're going to choose minimum. Okay, that's much better. now that we have that, I'm gonna clean up a bit my grid. To create the outline, we're going to need the background. So select media in, click on the background icon, and automatically it's going to create a merge node. Now we do have an issue. We don't see our footage anymore because the background is above the media in. To change this, grab the green arrow, pull it to the yellow, and reconnect the media in to the green. That's fixed. Now to create the outline, we simply need to select our two polygons. Ctrl C, unselect, Ctrl V, and we're gonna connect the polygon one to the background. The background disappeared because now it's only filling up the shape of both masks. To create the outline, with the polygon one node selected, go to border width, and here, drag to the right to add as much outline as you need. Okay, polygon number two, this time we're gonna drag to the left to create the outline inside the glasses. If you want to change the color of the outline, select the background, open up the color, and here, select something that's fit you need. I'm going to choose something fun. Okay. And while we're here, we're going to change the color of the cutout just to reinforce the effect. We're going to apply color corrector after the media in, control space, type color, color corrector, add, and here, adjust your need. I'm gonna pop the contrast, bit more saturation, same as the mask, we can update that later. Next, we're going to jump in the color tab, and here, I'm gonna remove all the saturation to bring it to black and white. Add some contrast to make it really pop. Let's go to the edit page and play our clip. Cool, it's working pretty well. Now we can go a bit further and add a parallax effect. For this, I'm going to go to the first frame, make sure that I have the background selected, add a keyframe for position and zoom, go to the last frame, and do the same thing. On the last frame, I'm going to move the clip on the x-axis to the left. As you can see, I'm revealing the outside of the clip, so I will zoom in slightly, just to reinforce the effect of the parallax. Let's try. Cool. I won't need it this time, but you could very well add the same effects to the upper clip and move your subject around. In the effect library, choose the title of your choice, bring it to the top, resize it so it fits the rest of the clip, and I'm going to change the text for something that blue totally agrees on. Update the font to your needs. There, perfect. Drag the title under the upper clip. In the layout, I'm gonna add some rotation to the text. And now it's time to animate it. We're going to add a keyframe on the first frame, move three frames to the right, add another keyframe, go to the last frame, and add a third keyframe. Back to the first keyframe, we're going to move the text out of the frame, move it down. We're gonna go to the last keyframe, and here, we're gonna move it to the right, just to add some lasting motion to our effect. Let's add some extra style to our transition by going to video transition. I'm gonna grab blur dissolve, add it to our upper frame, and we're gonna retime it at 0.3. Let's check this out. Really cool. Now, this is just one effect among many. Try adding some camera shake, for example. The next step would be to add some sound design like we did in our video. If you enjoyed this video, leave a thumbs up and maybe check our playlist about VFX and DaVinci Resolve. And we'll see you in the next video. Peace.